I'd like to call the city council meeting for Roseville to order for October 9, 2012. May we please rise and pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
At this time, over the weekend, a good friend of ours and a community activist and a school board member for the Roseville Community Schools passed away. So I'd like to take a moment of silence for Mr. Bob Einiker. Thank you. At this time, under presentation and proclamation, we're going to have the presentation of the 2012 Leonard Haggerty Beautification Awards. Can I have Joanne DeSuccio meet me down, along with the council? Ms. Joanne, the floor is yours.
Oh, dear. Okay. I want to thank Mayor Cherkin and Council for your support in helping us acknowledge the winners of the Leonard Haggerty Beautification Award. Before we announce the winners, allow me to tell you a little about us. We have been in existence since 1975. At that time, Mayor Haggerty saw the need of a Roseville Beautification Commission and a volunteer committee was formed. These are a few of our projects we are very proud of. We started the first Christmas tree lighting ceremony. Needless to say, it was in the basement of City Hall. Since then, we've been to several different. Well, we got larger and bigger and bigger, and finally we got deer and all that kind of stuff, but it got too much for us, so we had to say, help, help, help. Beautifying Utica Junction was another big project. It says that there's a lot of history that took place there, as well as it's our so-called downtown Roseville. Entrance signs at the north and south end of Gratiot. And the landscaping that goes around the signs. The many trees, many of the trees that are planted in the median, at one time we had, it was called a memorial tree program or something. And of course the big thing tonight is the Leonard Haggerty Beautification Award. At this time, I would like to introduce the Beautification Commission. Alma Jamras is our chairperson. Rita Lenz is a commissioner. Not present is Rita Wilson, Janet Carter, and Kay Einigner. And I know I'm going to say that wrong. Right? Okay, good. And I'm Joanne DeSuccio, and I'm honored to announce our winners. So as I call your names, would you please come forward this way? Okay, let's see.
We gotta open the microphone that is closed.
Huh?
The microphone is closed.
You have to talk louder.
Is it open?
It's true.
Can everybody hear?
Just don't leave it alone.
I have a one. I had six kids, so you know I can yell. And 14 grandchildren, I'm good. Now, can you hear me okay? Okay. Brian and Michelle Doyle.
Thank you again. Thank you, Brian.
Mark and Linda Billings. Mr. Billings informed us that he was fishing up north and came back just for this this award, so we're really proud of him.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Great job.
Thank you. Thank you.
Quarino Longo. Vito Lucia.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Alfred and Ines Cardillo. Brenda Rucker. John and Carla Wendling. Virginia Karp. Michael and Lucy Allen. Christine Malkowitz. I was going to say in Polish.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm even proud because my husband has women.
Go for you.
Thank you very much.
Rose Jenkins and Dennis Jenkins. Mary and Robert Killewald. Howard and Suzanne Lefevre. Liz McGuire.
Oh, yeah. Bodyguard.
David Jacobs.
She blew it, I didn't do it.
Typical man.
We're going to ask a show.
Thank you.
He does the login.
Thank you. We have a senior citizen tonight that's 98 years old, and her name is Florence Pinko, and her son John Pinko. Did I miss anyone? Everyone was comfortable. Thank you for all your hard work in helping beautify our city. And hopefully, more people will see the importance of keeping our city attractive and let everyone know how proud we are to live in Roseville.
Oh, yeah.
If you, as winners, have any suggestions or visions you would like to see accomplished by our commission, please contact us through the city clerk's office. Again, thank you, and continue to make Roseville a beautiful and desirable place to live.
Ladies, on behalf of myself and the City Council, we'd like to thank you for all your hard work and dedication to make this event happen tonight. Thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause for our beautification committee.
Under routine matters, approval of minutes of special meeting held September 18, 2012.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty, supported by Councilman Iuro. Is there any discussion on the minutes? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is approval of minutes of regular meeting held September 25, 2012.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor, supported by Councilwoman McCartney. Is there any discussion on the minutes? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next is approval of disbursement list.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Shoemaker, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. Is there any discussion on the disbursement list this evening? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Mr. Clerk, do we have any correspondence this evening?
Mayor, I have no correspondence, but I would like to indicate that the absentee ballots have been mailed out today. Anybody wishing to request an absentee ballot can still do so up until Saturday before the election. Other than that, I'd just like to take a brief opportunity as well to offer my condolences to the family of Bob Einiger. As indicated, Bob was very, very active in the community, and born and raised in Roseville, and gave back a lot to the community, and he will be missed. That's all I have.
Thank you. Next item is hearing of the public. The first hearing is for agenda items only. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address, address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions, input information, and or express opinions to the council. Anyone using inappropriate language will be called out of order and will correct their language or leave the podium. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules will be called out of order by the chair. Does anybody from the public wish to be heard on agenda items only this evening? Anybody from the public wish to be heard on agenda items only? Seeing none, we will move into new business. But first, can I have an addendum to the agenda. I would like to put on a closed door session for contract negotiations. So can I get a motion for that, please?
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Iuto, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. Mr. Clerk, can we have a roll call vote?
Certainly. Councilwoman McCartney?
Yes.
Councilman Taylor?
Yes.
Councilwoman Hagerty?
Yes.
Mayor Cherkin?
Yes.
Councilman Ayuda?
Yes.
Councilman Shoemaker?
Yes.
Councilman Spitalski?
Yes.
Seven positive votes, Mayor, motion carried.
Thank you. Next item under new business is request from the Give a Gift Foundation to solicit donations on city streets October 25th through 27th. Proceeds to benefit cancer patients. Kim Moyer's petitioner. Ms. Moyer's in the audience.
Good evening, Council. My name is Christina Krupa, KRUPA, with the Give a Gift Foundation. I'm a board member.
Your address, please?
28351 Gresham Avenue, Suite 3.
Thank you.
And yes, again, we are requesting your permission to solicit in the streets on the weekend of October 25th through the 27th. All of our proceeds go directly to cancer patients from the people that live in the Roseville City that goes through there nice enough to donate to us, and to the bank right to the hand of our patients. We help them with their everyday needs, or sometimes they may have to apply for assistance and it takes some time to get that assistance. We're there for them right away. We help them with rent generally, gas cards, food cards, and things of that nature.
Okay. Are there any questions for the petitioner this evening? Councilwoman McCartney?
What type of stipend do your collectors get? I mean, how much of the proceeds actually go to the patients?
All the proceeds that we collect, our solicitors that solicit for us, we do pay a minimum wage for them, but the rest of the money that we collect, all of it goes to the
patients. Do you have like a ballpark figure of how many solicitors you have out there compared to the money you're collecting?
This year's been really small compared to other years. It was just a rough year for finding people who are eligible to do this. Maybe they found better jobs and whatnot, which we're very happy for them. Mm-hmm. Right now, we currently have about 6 people that collect for us. So we're usually just in 1 or 2 intersections, where before last year we had a much bigger calling of volunteers and people that we would pay to do it, and we would do maybe 5 or 6 intersections. So
this would be for the 25th, 26th, and 27th from those hours?
Yes.
That you would have a solicitor out there?
Yes.
That's all I have. Okay.
Any other questions? Councilman Ayuda.
Where do you find your solicitors that you pay?
They're generally friends of our family. It's a family foundation, so it's usually generally by that.
So it's friends and family that you pay minimum wage to?
Yes.
That go out on the streets and collect?
Correct.
Is the money secured in a box, in a can, or is it?
It's counted by 2 of the board members and signed off on and took to the bank that night that we collected. So we collect 3 days a week. We go to the bank 3 days a week. At the end of the night, at the end of the evening, it's tilled up. We add it up and we put it in a night depository bank.
Is there ever time that it's not a family member?
We do have some friends that aren't family members, yes. That is true, that collect for us, but they are kind of linked within the family somehow.
Okay, that is all. Thank you.
Okay.
Just how much did you raise last year?
How much did we raise
from
last
year? In Roseville.
In Roseville. Let me think about that. That's a good question. Last year was a pretty good year. I know we came up here, I believe 3 times. And generally when we come up here, I probably would give it a ballpark figure about $3,000 to $4,000.
Total?
Total, yes.
Okay. And how many people did you have working?
Last year it was probably closer to 15.
15 people for 3 days each?
Yes.
They're out there about 8 hours?
From 9 in the morning until 7 p.m. Sometimes we call it if it's weather, if it's a slow day, we'll call it early and let them go home and get some rest because it is long hours, but.
Yeah, so they're out there about 10 hours.
Yeah, they're dedicated to the cause, the people that we have. It's a hard job. It's not an easy job to be out there all those hours, and they're very dedicated to what we do.
Okay. That's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Yeah, thank you for the disclosure. I wasn't aware that they were receiving minimum wage. City Manager, Mr. Atkins, this is probably the only group that, from our knowledge, would actually do it this way, wouldn't they? Most of it's completely volunteer services?
Yes, in most cases, they are local community organizations, and it's their membership that volunteers for the effort.
Thank you. That's all I have, Mayor.
Mayor Pro Tem.
And does any of the proceeds from this collection go towards the rent or the payment of the office that you guys have, the suite 4 on Gresham there?
Yes, it does help with the rent.
Okay. That's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Any other questions? Councilman Smithowski.
So I'd say probably a quarter of what you raise goes to pay the solicitors then.
Well, it's hard to give an exact amount because each city that we do all cities.
But based on your experience in Roseville, would I be far off to say a quarter to a third of it goes to solicitors?
Probably this year, yes. Depends on how many we have.
Okay. All right, that's all I have.
All right. How many cities do you solicit in?
Let's see, I don't really, can't give you a number off the top of my head, but Roseville, we do like around here. Roseville, we do Chesterfield, we do Warren, Fraser, Utica.
Okay.
Harrison Township we were doing, and New Baltimore also.
Okay. And have you've been in Gratiot since your inception?
I'm sorry?
You've had your office in Roseville since the inception?
Actually, we were on Van Dyke prior, and we moved over to this office. We've been there 2 years now. At this address, yes, we've been there 2 years.
Okay. All right, thank you. Any other questions? What's the wishes of the council?
Mr. Mayor, I'll make the motion to approve the request.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Switowski to approve the request, supported by Councilman Shoemaker. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion.
I'm opposed.
Yeah.
Okay, show two oppositions, Councilwoman McCartney and Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. Motion passes. Good luck, ladies.
Thank you very much. And we'd also like to thank the residents for their diligence and effort helping us. Thank you.
Thank you. Next item is a request from Parks and Rec to conduct the 33rd annual Big Bird Run on City Street, Sunday, November 11th, 2012, from 10 to 11:30 a.m. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of council, as you're aware, it is almost that time of year again for the annual Big Bird Run. You have a request before you this evening to approve this event. We held on Sunday, November 11th, 2012, from 10 to 11:30 a.m. It has been reviewed by Police Chief Berlin, and he recommends approval of the request. There have been no incidents in the past, and it's a very welcomed event and a very well-supported event for our community.
Any questions for the city manager regarding the Big Bird Run? Mayor Pro Tem Taylor, are you going to race Councilman Shoemaker this year?
It could happen. I'm not saying it's going to, I'd say it could happen.
Okay. I'm ready for that, Mayor.
Ooh. Okay.
It's not like a public challenge. All right. Just keep calling me. Yeah.
Anyways, I have them. Any other further questions? Can I have a motion now?
Mayor will make the motion to approve the request for Parks and Recreation to conduct the 33rd annual Big Bird Run on City Streets, Sunday, November 11th, 2012.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. I want to remind Councilman Shoemaker that Mr. Taylor came in third in his age class a couple years ago. So.
Throw down the gauntlet.
There you go. Any other further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request to set public hearing date in connection with application to create a commercial rehabilitation exemption certificate for C.H. McComb, LLC, 20891 East 13 Mile Road. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of council, you have before you the request. We have received the application from C.H. McComb, LLC. This is in regards to the commercial rehabilitation district that has been established recently by council. We would ask for an establishment of the public hearing to be set for October 23rd.
October 23rd?
Correct.
Okay. Are there any questions from Mr. Atkins regarding this matter? Seeing none, can I have a motion to set the hearing date for October 23rd?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to set the public hearing for October 23rd.
Support.
Sorry.
Motion by Councilman Ayudo to set the hearing date as October 23rd, 2012, supported by Councilman Switowski. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request to set public hearing date in connection with application to amend an industrial development district and create an industrial facilities exemption certificate for RCO Engineering, Inc., 29100 Callahan Road, 29200 Callahan Road, and 29300 Callahan Road, and 15711 12 Mile Road, and 1572512 Mile Road. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, council members. We have received an application from RCO requesting to amend the district that's currently established to include 1572512 Mile Road. This would be for an expansion project. This request is for a new IFT for all five of the properties. The group will be present to make a presentation to council at a special meeting next week. We'd ask that this be set for public hearing on October 23rd as well.
Okay, are there any questions regarding this matter for the city manager? Seeing none, can I have a motion to set the hearing date?
Mr. Mayor, I'll make a motion to set the public hearing for October 23rd for the RCO certificates.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Sulawski to set the public hearing date for the industrial facilities exemption certificate for RCO engineering for October 23rd, 2012, supported by Councilwoman McCartney. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request to set public hearing date in connection with application to create an industrial facilities exemption certificate for RCO Engineering, Inc., 15686 Sturgeon. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of council, we have a separate application from RCO in regards to the location at 15686 Sturgeon. This would be requesting also an approval of an industrial facilities tax exemption. Again, there'll be a presentation on October 16th and a request that the public hearing be set for October 23rd. This is for a new project with job retention and also creation, and you have information in your packet.
Okay. Are there any questions for the city manager regarding this item? To set a public hearing date once again on October 23rd. Seeing no questions, can I have a motion setting the date, please?
Mayor, I move to set a hearing date of October 23rd for application for IFT for RCO for 15686 Sturgeon.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Shoemaker, supported by Councilman Swatowski. Is there any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request to set public hearing date in connection with application to establish a plant rehabilitation district and create an industrial facilities exemption certificate for American Modular Tooling LLC, Paul W. Marino Gauges, Inc., 30744 Grossbeck Highway and 30812 Grossbeck Highway. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of council, we received an application from American Modular. It's a new business application to establish a plant rehabilitation district and create a new IFT for the locations mentioned on Grossbeck. Again, we would expect a presentation from the group on October 16th and request a public hearing be set for October 23rd in regards to this matter.
Okay. Are there any questions to Mr. Atkins on this matter? Councilman Sutowski.
So we have three of these that night.
Yes. Actually, you have more if you take the one separate issue, which is RCO. That's a multiple piece on a transfer.
Yeah.
Then you have two pieces of action on this current request. Plant Rehabilitation Act in regards to the building which they're planning on occupying. So it is a little bit different of an approach that we've taken in the past.
So should I draw any conclusion from the fact that we have three? Is it business picking up? Or?
Well, we're hoping it's a sign that business is picking up. In this case, the one that you have before you right now, we're looking at a building which actually is a functionally obsolete building that we really weren't having much hope for any type of action. So it is a pleasant surprise for us in this case that somebody is looking at taking a building that was written off at one point. So we look at that as a glimmer of hope.
So is the phone ringing more in economic development? Are you getting more inquiries?
It actually is. Okay. So we see that as an encouraging sign.
The other thing you have too is you have an October 31st deadline that these have to be, action has to be taken by. So that's why we always have an influx of these, it seems, at the end of September, beginning of October.
Otherwise, they have to wait till the next year? Or
correct.
Okay. So I shouldn't get too excited.
Just trying to temper it a little bit.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Councilman Ayuto.
I was just wondering if Mr. Atkins could elaborate a little bit on a plant rehabilitation as opposed to the commercial rehabilitation we did earlier.
to kind of summarize it as simply as I can at this point, and we'll talk a little bit more in detail next week, but the real difference is, in this case, the plant rehabilitation, we're looking at an existing facility that's going to be reused and reclamated for use. It's considered, as I mentioned, functionally obsolete, so it's outlived its original purpose. There is a mechanism set by state statute to allow for a plant rehabilitation act in order to be able to salvage, in essence, the existing building and put it into reclaimed use. Whereas in most cases, the Commercial Rehabilitation Act is looking at a complete demolition or green build in a new area. So this is actually looking at reclaiming an existing facility for use and a retrofit. They're very similar on the process that we go through as far as the incentive packages that are available, but there is a distinct difference between the type of applications that each can be applied for.
Thank you.
I hope that helped.
Any other questions? Seeing none, can I have a motion to set the public hearing date?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to set the public hearing date for October 23rd for Plant Rehabilitation District for American Modular Tooling at 30744 Grosbeck Highway and 30810 Grosbeck Highway.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Ayudo to set the hearing date October 23rd, 2012, supported by Councilman Hagerty. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request to set public hearing date in conjunction with application to transfer an industrial facilities exemption certificate from the City of Warren to the City of Roseville, American Modular Tooling LLC, Paul Marino Gauges, Inc., 30744 Grosbeck Highway. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of Council. This project that we're discussing is actually a transfer project coming to the City of Roseville from the City of Warren. They currently have an existing IFT at their facility in Warren. They'll be requesting, through the public hearing process, a transfer of that IFT from Warren to Roseville. So it would be for the remaining portions of the term of the original IFT. It will result in job creation and also additional investment within the city. So this, again, will be set for public hearing, and we'll be looking at a transfer of the existing IFT for the remaining period of time from Warren to Roseville.
Are there any questions on that? Mr. Tomlinson,
mm-hmm.
When we transfer these IFTs, do we have to take them as they are from under the state statute, or can they be modified?
Typically, it's the transfer is accepted as it is.
Okay. All right, thank you. So October 23rd is your date for that, also?
That is correct.
Okay. All right. Can I have a motion to set the public hearing date?
Mr. Mayor, I make a motion to set the public hearing for October 23rd for the transfer of the IFC as described in the agenda.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Swatowski, supported by Councilwoman McCartney. Is there any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request awarding of bid for board up services. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of Council. We had previous discussion concerning the board up services that we have had under contract in the past. A request for proposals and bid was sent out to 8 different companies. 4 companies responded with quotes. The low bid meeting the specifications was submitted by Jarvis Property Restoration in the amount of $125 minimum per house, with a square foot cost for the final first floor of $1.25 per square foot and the second floor of $1.75. The city has done business with Jarvis Restoration in the past. They were the last contract awardee for board up services, and there has been no change from their previous bid. Therefore, it's recommended that Council consider the acceptance and award the bid to Jarvis Property Restoration in the amounts $125 per minimum, with a square foot, first floor $1.25, and second floor $1.75 per square foot.
Any questions regarding this? Can I have a motion?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to award the bid to the lowest responsible bidder, Jarvis Property Restoration.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Swatowski to award the bid to Jarvis Constructive, supported by Councilwoman Hagerty. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item are appointments, and I have a couple. To the Elected Officials Compensation Pay Board, I would like to appoint Richard Eubanks. Term is 7 years, taking the position of Ronald McCool that expired on October 1st, 2012. Appointment appointment by mayor and confirmed by council. So can I have a motion?
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty, supported by Councilman Swatowski. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is appointment of planning commission. I have three reappointments: Cremel Knox, Joseph Montgomery, and Otto Wilhelm. And the term is 3 years, expiration date October 9, 2012. So can I have a motion, please?
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman McCartney, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor, to reappoint Cremel Knox, Joseph Montgomery, and Otto Wilhelm. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. They are appointed, reappointed. Next item is reports of city manager, Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, members of council, I have a few items for you this evening. One, to kind of tag along with the comment that Councilmember Swatowski had made concerning the phones ringing off the hook with development. We do feel that there are some signs of positive things yet to come here in the city. We have been very busy, not just based upon the deadlines for these IFT requests that have to be in prior to the 31st, but a lot of inquiries on new potential startups or expansions. The plant rehabilitation project that we have is a very interesting and unique project. Again, we're encouraged by the fact that somebody's looking at taking a building which otherwise may have sat vacant and trying to put it into an active use and back onto the tax roll, even with an abatement on a more positive tax note than we've had in the past. I would tell you that this week we have scheduled three meetings with various parties that are interested in development within the city. And that seems to be a pretty good sign or indication. So the redevelopment team is hard at work. Planning Commission is working along with us now, and we look to be able to expand to our full seven members to hit the ground running on the redevelopment projects. We will have a presentation for the council coming up here in the near future on how we expect our business one-stop to kick off to help enhance business. So we're encouraged by the activities that are happening. The library would like to announce two events that they have. Wednesday, October 17th at 6:30, they have an evening with author John Carlisle. John has written a book entitled 313, Life in the Motor City. He's a columnist with Our Detroit Magazine and the Metro Times, and also an editor at CNG Newspapers. So it should be an interesting program for those that are able to attend. Refreshments will be served, and copies of the book will be available that evening. And then also, Tuesday, October 16th, I guess these are kind of in a backwards order, but the day before that, the library has a program at 6:30. It's a presentation by Dr. Jim McConnell on the Forgotten War, the War of 1812. And that does seem to be the Forgotten War that kind of went right across our front and backyards in the area here. So interesting programs that the library has. Engineering has advised some updates on the 2012 city projects. Groveland, both sections have been completed with the exception of some small punch list items. Common Road, the contractor is pouring the eastbound lane of Common Road. Today they started at Gratiot Avenue heading west, and I know that they were working diligently out there today. They expect, if the weather cooperates, to have this done over the next 3 days for the pouring of the concrete, and the traffic will remain westbound until the completion of the project. The joint seal program is completed with the prep work in the target area of 10 Mile to Frazo and Hayes to Gratiot. Also some minor seal work is also being finished. We have some open sanitary sewer repairs that are being made. The contractor will start that work next week on October 15th. And the county continues to wrap up resurfacing on Utica between Gratiot and 14, which will begin at the end of this week. And they also have the rest of their completion on some of the traffic signals that they're wrapping up. So we're getting to towards the end of the season. Things seem to be falling in place, and we hope that those projects will be wrapped up. We are looking at trying to finalize some details with Department of Transportation on some of the growth spec work that was planned, and also some of our additional work projects that were approved by council here a couple of meetings ago. So as soon as those calendars are put into place, I'll be glad to share those with you in regards to the projects dealing with any of the connector ramps or growth spec. That's all I have for you at this time. Be glad to answer any questions.
Are there any questions for Mr. Atkins this evening? Councilman Ayudo.
Mr. Atkins, I just had a question regarding the government channel on cable.
Yes, sir.
Every once in a while, that computer freezes up, and it usually happens sort of on a Friday night, and it doesn't get fixed again until Monday morning when somebody comes in the office. Is there a way that we could have somebody have remote access to that computer so that if it does freeze up, they get notified and can remote in, reboot that computer, and residents don't have to wait until Monday?
I will check with information services tomorrow, but I'm sure that we should be able to set up some type of remote access for that. But I'll be glad to look into that for you and have an answer.
Thank you.
Any other questions, Councilman Sotoski?
One other. Scott, we talked a couple of months ago about having a temporary code enforcement for the summer months. Can you kind of update us on what we've done there?
Yes, we have just recently brought on board a new code enforcement officer as a temporary officer. We also are going to have a personnel change in one of our regular code enforcement officers. So we may, in fact, be shifting the new hire, who's done an exceptional job, has received his rodent control certification, into more of those allotted hours, and then looking at replacing that part-time position with another new hire. But it has worked out well for us. It has increased the closure rate on many of our ordinance issues. And speaking with Mr. Sexton earlier today, he's been very pleased with the pickup that this new officer has been able to undertake. So I'm hopeful that we'll be able to make another positive shift here and replace that part-time position in the near future with a new hire.
Okay, and it was for, I don't think we gave you full year funding. We
correct.
Paid out a certain amount.
We had part year, but we did not get this person on immediately, so we still have some availability in the funding to be able to wrap up the fall season here before the snow falls.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Right. Any other questions? Seeing none, we'll move into reports of city attorney. Mr. Thomas.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. The only thing I have to report is myself and Mr. Sexton appeared in the Macomb County Circuit Court on 5 of our nuisance abatements. We did receive judgments in those particular cases, which will allow us to demolish the structures or homes and or garages that were dilapidated. I would anticipate, because we do these on a constant rotating basis, that you'll be seeing resolutions coming back before you for other homes there. They're basically are in the same situation that we will be seeking to demolish and or rehabilitate. Other than that, I have nothing further to report.
Are there any questions for Mr. Tomlinson? Seeing none, we will move into the hearing of the public for the second public hearing. Approaching the podium, please state your name and address the chair, and welcome to direct questions, input information, and express opinions to the council. Anyone using inappropriate language will be called out of order. Conduct their language or leave the podium. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Yes, ma'am.
My name is Martha Cusimano. I live at 28744 Barkman. I've been down here 3 times, talked to 3 different people, and cannot get an answer to our questions on my water bill. The clerks don't know anything. I was in Mr. Atkins' office. He was at a seminar, and nobody there could answer the question. They connected me to the water department, and the only answer I got is, it is what it is. Now I want to know, what is a local operating maintenance fee? And ready to serve charge. Ready to serve what?
Is that your only questions, ma'am? Mr.
Atkins? Can I get an answer?
Yes. The local operating fee is a system fee for the system itself. It covers some of the overhead costs. The ready-to-serve charge is a common charge to all users of the water system because you have water availability. So it's common not just in Roseville, but many municipalities as part of the system charges. I'd be glad to go over that with you and try to explain it a little bit further by looking at your bill.
Well, I've talked to people in the city of Detroit. They don't have those on their bill. I've talked to people in Warren. They don't have those charges. Frazier doesn't have those charges. I haven't made it to East Point yet to contact anybody, but it seems like we're the only one got those charges on our bill.
Many communities have charges, but they may call them different types of names. They're not always called ready
to
serve.
They only have 2 fees, water and sewage treatment. That's it.
Quite honestly, most of the time, a lot of communities don't break them out like we do, because you can adjust those fees if they're broken out. Some of them just wrap it up in a total fee for sewer or water instead of breaking it down for the residents. We actually go the extra step because sometimes those can be adjusted in a more favorable way to the residents. Ready to serve is an example. The more users of the system, the less that ready to serve charge typically is in most communities. So we break ours out. A lot of communities still don't do that. And so that may be the discrepancy you're seeing.
I mean, are we going to continue getting over $300 water bills?
I'd really have to look at your bill and see what the use rate is and
you
have it broke down.
You want to see it?
Yeah, I would be willing
after
to help
the
you.
Meeting, man, you can give yeah. your you can give your water
and
bill.
And I'd like to get a copy of it if I could from after the meeting. I might not be able to get all of your answers this evening, but I certainly will look into the history of the account.
And why can't we get them every month like Warren?
Well, our system bills currently on a quarterly basis.
But is it that hard to change a computer?
Well, it costs more. Mm-hmm.
Well, there are some technology pieces with that. They may have different type of setup than what we have. But I'll be glad to look at that after the meeting.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Anybody else from the public wish to be heard this evening? Anybody else from the public wish to be heard? Yes, sir.
Dave Chesney, 30440 Normal. And I brought this up to you guys before about the Speedway gas station on Gratiot and Martin with their ongoing problem of not having a restroom in there because they say they're having plumbing problems or sewer problems. And I've had it out with the manager up there about it because, you know, I'm a regular customer and I'm getting pretty ticked off about it. And so are a lot of people. You know, they got this port-a-john out there sitting out back in the parking lot there. They don't come and clean it out, and it's starting to really, it smells like an open sewer. You know, that's what customers and employees got to deal with. Now, Speedway is owned by Marathon Oil, a big multi-million dollar corporation. You mean to tell me they can't fix their sewer line that goes out to the main, or the city can't make them fix it? Because I'm telling you, we need to boycott that gas station until they fix their plumbing problem. This is Roseville, Michigan, USA, not Karachi, Pakistan, or Bombay, India, where they have open toilets that little old ladies clean out by hand. You know, it's ridiculous over there. And they, you know, the city's got to step in, make them fix their problem, and stop getting excuses from the manager over there. You know, Speedway is, like I say, it's a multi-million dollar corporation. And then their corporate lawyers come in and they just lollygag about it and they don't want to fix the problem, which is bad for the customers and for the employees who work there, who probably work hard for what they can't even use a restroom. So, this is what has to be fixed over there. Because I'm not giving them my business no more. I'll go to 13 and Little Mac or 13 and Hayes. At least their restrooms work. This has been ridiculous. It's been going on for over a year, and something needs to be done. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else from the public wish to be heard this evening? Anybody else wish to be heard? Seeing none, we'll move into items for discussion by City Council. Councilman Sotowski.
Yeah, my condolences to the Heinecker family. Going to miss Bob. But I got two items. One is, can we do a quarterly budget review at our next study session to just track where we are on the budget. Are we on target? Have we brought in revenue what we thought? Have our expenses been what we thought? Is our fund balance where we anticipated? So just each quarter, if we can just have a review of where we stand on the budget. And just one other thing for that study session is, we've had some discussion about solicitation on the streets, and if we want to talk about, you know, some limitations on number of days or whether you can have paid solicitors, that'd be a good thing to hash out at a study session, come up with a consistent policy.
If I may, Your Honor, we are planning. I think my time is up.
Am I out of time?
But you can't hear it.
You can't hear it.
We are planning on having a special budget workshop. It most likely will be early November. Mr. Katie has been working on all the numbers of the closeout from the quarter, so it is our intention to have that quarterly budget meeting for you. Probably be a special session first part of November. Because of the timeliness that we have, or lack thereof, at the session next week dealing with these other issues, we'll probably do that 2 weeks afterwards.
That's fine.
And certainly I will look into those other items for you as well.
Yeah, that's fine.
Councilman Ayudo.
Thank you, Mayor. I want to reiterate the condolences to the Heinecker family. Bob was always a hoot when we have the meat raffle, and he had that microphone in his hand. So I'm going to miss Bob. The Recreation Authority, we are accepting sponsors for space at the Trick or Trunk event coming up on the 27th of this month. Actually over at Veterans Memorial Park between 6 and 7. It's our first year trying it this way, that people that want to have a table or be able to give out goodies to the kids. There's going to be about 350 kids, we estimate. And that's the 27th of this month from 6 to 7 at Veterans Memorial. Also, we're still selling the wristbands for the kids who can go collect the candy and trick-or-treat at this park with you know, a supervised safe area. And those wristbands are $3 a piece. And with the council's approval tonight, the Recreation Authority is also now going to take registrations for the 34th annual Big Bird Run, even though our agenda said 33rd. The event is scheduled for Sunday, November the 11th, and there's a 10K, 4K, and 1 mile fun run. So still a lot of good things happening at the Recreation Department, the Recreation Authority of East Point and Roseville. That's all I have. Take care of each other.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Thank you, Mayor. I too want to give my condolences out to Bob Einecker's family. Sorry for your family's loss. Bob was a longtime school board member, and he wore several hats in his service to the community. Congratulations to all the Leonard Haggerty Beautification Award recipients and to everybody out there in Roseville that keeps up the property, making it look nice. It's good for our image in Roseville. Is anybody up here going to mention the meat raffle, or should I say something here?
Go ahead.
Yeah, meat raffle is going to be Saturday, October 20th. I don't have the details. You guys know it. I know it's at the VFW Hall. I think
doors open at 6.
Yeah.
So the raffle starts at 7.
Always a great time. I thought you were going to segue into that.
I should have.
Okay, and then I may have got myself in trouble, Bob. How fast you run last year? But I'm gonna start turning tomorrow. So that's all I have there.
All right, thank you. Councilwoman Haggerty.
I'd also like to congratulate all the recipients of the Beautification Award. It's nice to have people take an interest in the beautification of Roseville. We need more of that that philosophy and idea in our city. And my sincere condolences to the Bob Einecker family. We will all miss him greatly. He was a great tribute, and he gave a lot to the city, so we will miss him. And that's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Councilwoman McCartney.
Thank you, Mayor. To the Bob Einecker. Bob's served the school board for many, many years, and recently he was the bond coordinator for the school. Not only did he serve the city, but he also served his country. So to Kay Einecker and your family, his wife Kay, thoughts and prayers, loves and kisses to all of you. Homecoming this weekend. Pancake breakfast is from 7 to 9. Adults are $4, $2 for children, and that's at the RHS cafeteria. The parade starts at 10 a.m. It's a new route. We're starting at Eastland Middle School parking lot this year, down Frank, left on Normal, and into the Roseville High School staff lot. Because of the construction on Common Road, obviously we won't be using Common. The football game starts at 1. The crowning will approximately be at 2, and we will be playing Utica. The dance starts at 7, will end about 10, so it's a fun-filled day for Roseville on Saturday. Meat raffle, you wanted to know, doors open at 6, raffle starts at 7:15. And to the beautification winners, congratulations. There's many people out there that keep up their lawns, businesses. That's what we need in Roseville. That's what makes us look good. All of the people out there that come up here and let us know what's going on in Roseville, the things that don't look right, we call, we send somebody out, and hopefully correct it for you. So thank you to all of you. It takes a whole community to keep the city looking good. So that's all I have.
Thank you. Mayor Pro Tem.
You guys cover just about everything down there. It's hard for me to cover all that. I'd like to congratulate John Surhai from the Roseville Optimist Club. He's going to be installed as our new Optimist Club president on Friday this week. I know John's looking forward to it. It's a lot of work, but I'd like to congratulate John. Also, with his other duties, he's also one of our planning board members, so I hope he's got time for the Optimist Club. Beautification Award winners, I saw some of the pictures of them homes, and they're phenomenal. I mean, I know I try to spend a lot of time on my house, my front yard, and my backyard, and I don't know how these people do it. They, you know, they got it looking really nice. It's, you guys are tough people to keep up with, I can tell you that, but I'm trying. To the Roseville Police Department, this last couple weeks, is our chief, James Berlin, has did, as far as I'm concerned, a wonderful job handling the press and all the different issues that our city's been dealing with. This possible Jimmy Hoffa situation, which fortunately for us turned up no Jimmy Hoffa, and I'm sort of glad about that. But he's handled himself very well as our, I guess you could say, rookie chief. And my sources are telling me that the situation that we had the other day over on Collingwood, where these, I guess you could say, thugs decided to carjack one of our residents and led to her injuries and or damage to her vehicle. It's my understanding that they've got some leads, and I know Chief Berlin will not rest until these people are put in jail. So I want the people in Roseville to realize that our police officers are out there and they're looking for these guys. Not to say that you still shouldn't be looking over your back, because you never know. But I feel confident that our police department will apprehend these people that are responsible and bring them to justice. On Bob Einiker, the Einiker family has been dear to this whole council and the whole city of Roseville. Bob's going to be deeply missed. Like Councilman Aiuto said at the meat raffle, Bob was the announcer of all the numbers, and he's been a mainstay down at the VFW, past post commander, and our VFW members are having a rough time down there lately. They've had a couple other members that have passed away, and my thoughts and prayers go not only with the Einikers, but with the VFW members of our post, 2358. And on that, that's all I have, Mr. Mayor. Oh, go Tigers tonight.
Well, thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. Today you've seen a bunch of individuals in our city that care about our city. There were 22 homes, I think, that were awarded beautification, the Letter and Hagerty Beautification Awards, and they're a credit to the community. You know, we live here. Some of us work here, and we recreate here. But I'm really, really happy that these people take the time out to fix their homes up and make them look beautiful, because then it makes the whole city of Roseville shine. And I really appreciate that. And to all the award winners, once again, I'd like to congratulate you. And hopefully next year we'll have 44 of them. I can't say how sorry I am and my condolences and sympathies to Kay Einiker and her family. With the passing of Bob. Bob was a dedicated person. He was a veteran, and he took his military service very seriously. He's a member of the 2358 VFW. He was what they call a cootie, was a member, a side member of their organization. He had a lot to do with the Handicap Association, the school board. He served for 22 years. He was on the PTO. Scholarship Foundation, Booster Club. He helped the kids show old cars. He was in the antique cars. And he will be missed. The city of Roseville lost one of their own, and he was a great man and a gentleman. And for those, some people know it, that the Handicap Association, when they do the Happy Handicap Olympics, they have a torch that they light. And Bob Einiker took his time out, and he built that torch. And so I would like to just give my condolences once again to the family. And with that, we'll go into a closed-door session to discuss contract negotiations. And I'd like to congratulate Richard Eubanks on his appointment as elected officials compensation board. With that, we will go into closed doors.